María de la Rosa, and I have been a partner with La Peña to bring Son Jarocho to La Peña's programming. I am a culture bearer in the community and lead Son Jarocho with a lot of friends throughout the Bay Area. Son Jarocho comes from the Sotavento region of Veracruz, which is the southern part of Veracruz. It's also the port of entry of the Spanish and the conquest of the Spanish of Mexico. And because of all that multicultural mixing, the music has three roots in it. The indigenous roots, the West African roots that came with the slave trade. There was a heavy slave trade into Mexico through the port of Veracruz, and the Spanish influence, but specifically the Moorish aspect of it because of the Moors that occupied Spain for 700 years. This music has a lot of blends. You're gonna hear influences of strings and minor tones, and then you're also gonna hear call and response and polyrhythms that come from the African tradition, and you're gonna hear sort of some pieces that feel very ritualistic and more repetitive and speaking about nature and about our surroundings, and those are some of the indigenous influences.
My name is Natalia Neira Retamal. I'm the co-executive director of La Peña Cultural Center. I've been here for 5 years, and throughout this time, I've helped to support hundreds of different events, as well as supporting the cultural traditions of the Latin American and Caribbean diaspora in the Bay Area. The pandemic has given us an opportunity to really think about the essence of what La Peña is here to do right now, recording cultural traditions, recording what our community does at La Peña, including performances, classes, community jams, and show the world that these are cultural traditions that have been underfunded, they've been underrepresented, but this is the time where we start to change that.
Specifically, you're going to see the Fandango setting, the style, in an adapted COVID situation. Fandango is about gathering and coming together and being very close to each other, and so we've had to make a lot of adaptations for that, and it's been a whole year, more than a year, that we've gotten together as a community. This is going to be one of the first times that a very small number of us are getting together. But Fandango is basically a jam session of Son Jarocho music. Today's Fandango is different because we're using microphones. You would never use a microphone in a Fandango, but we're using that to keep ourselves distanced, as well as the tarima is split up into several parts. Normally a tarima would be one space, and the dancers would be, you know, you could be this close to people and touching people. We can't do that right now. Those two things in particular, as well as the fact that this is staged. We're trying to keep as much improvisation as possible, but we did have to decide what we were going to do. You wouldn't normally do that in a Fandango. It would just happen. Several years ago, La Peña asked me how I would involve the Mexican-American community more deeply in the programming of La Peña, and my immediate response was Son Jarocho. La Peña is a place where a lot of people are already connected, and it's also a place where we can come in as a community, and it's sort of the reason why La Peña exists, is to bring community together, to have these community jam type events, and Fandango is completely about that. We started doing monthly jam sessions, monthly Fandangos. We had a constant flow of interchange between here and Veracruz, and we got to about 5 years. February of 2020 was about 5 years exactly, and we shut down. That was the last one we had.
Por favor, se lo digo.
lost people. We lost at least one of our maestros who died from COVID. Personally, I know people that we've lost. It's affected all of us. Some people get it, some people don't get it, some people die from it, some people don't. But it has hit our community very hard, the Latino community in general. I work in the school districts, and that has been the charge of the teachers in the schools, is keeping our communities and students and families, holding a space for them, and absorbing the trauma that they're going through at the same time that we're going through it. Dancing on the tarima, you're in each other's faces, and that can't happen anymore, you know? We have to be very careful about how that happens. Those are the things that we're exploring and figuring out what can and can't happen, and how can we be safe about that without destroying community, without destroying the purpose of the Fandango, which is to gather, to be together, share our energies, build resilience, being able to resist all the things that we deal with every day. We can do that when we have this group of friends that have like values and such.
Pausado. Si hay una cosa que hemos aprendido de la cuarentena es pausar. Pausamos, respiramos. Eso. Dedicamos este son, el son de la morena, a toda la raza morena que hemos perdido en este tiempo. Por favor, a los maestros, algunos, a los familiares, a los parientes, a todos que contrataron el virus, y también a los que sobrevivieron, también estamos muy afectados en muchas maneras, mucha trauma. El son de la morena, dedicado a la raza morena, por favor. The biggest takeaway that I've had about the pandemic in relation to life in general and
you know, this is my life, what I do with Son Jarocho and Fandango, is that we need to be more pausados. We need to slow down, and we need to have silence, and we need to respect that silence, and we need to respect Mother Nature. I mean, this virus came from nature. We are sharing a space. We are sharing earth. We are sharing nature. We are sharing el medio ambiente. And this virus is just as much a part of it as humans are. And I think that there's a lot of reflection for that in me, that we have to respect that we don't just go and do whatever. You know, we can't just rip out, you know, trees and bulldoze fields, you know, because there's an effect. We're destroying other people's homes, other animals' homes, you know, and it affects us. That's what I feel like is the big thing. And when everything shut down, seeing animals in the street, they came out, you know, because they're like, they were able to reclaim what was theirs too, you know, and that is something that I feel like is really important. I mean, that we need to stop and remember that and just slow down and listen and connect and respect. Respect, that's the big thing.
Is about bringing the whole community together at different levels. So we have teaching artists and oftentimes even like master teaching artists. We have people who are students who are taking workshops with María regularly. You are there with your maestra, your typical weekly teacher, a master Son Jarocho dynasty family artist, your kids, you know, your friends, people who are just eating at the restaurant or enjoying a drink, just vibing with each other. And there's like this whole ecosystem of how these people are connected through this cultural tradition, and that we're all community coming together. That's the spirit of the community jam, and in this case, in the Fandango. When you come here now to a space like this, where we're having to creatively see how do we pick back right up where we left off? Well, we need this little pause to be like, well, where are we at? And these community jam recordings are allowing us to be in this moment, exactly where we are at this place when the pandemic is curving. We're seeing an opportunity to be able to come back into the space again.
Having a space like La Peña, it feels really important as spaces disappear. La Peña's been around as long as I can remember, really. And you can feel like a sort of like a hole in the community when the community space is taken away. And it's like just kind of that struggle to always be looking for places to come together. And I think that a space like that, it's like it's for everyone, and everyone is welcome, and everyone has equal access to that space. We don't charge. Everybody's welcome. You know, you don't have to play. You can come and learn. And it's just like an open It's an open space. People come there to connect, and it forms a community. And I think that's one of the important spaces is La Peña.
Why we have held on to the space is because it's important to have a space that is not somebody's home and that we can come to on a consistent basis. And so we need to be able to do that safely. What I would like to see as La Peña opens its doors in relation to Fandango and Son Jarocho and the community that practices this is being a leader in what are safety protocols and being able to provide that information for us. We're going to need some guidance from the organization, having information out there for our community, because there's a lot of people that don't know about testing, they don't know about what the protocols are, they don't know how and when to get the vaccine. La Peña, in its mission, can be closely aligned with opening up and opening up safely for our community and the others that use the space.
We sometimes have to fragment ourselves when we show up to different spaces, because you're showing up as a performer or you're showing up as like the event planner. But in this case, with the community jams, it really is a space for you to come bring your whole self. That's what these community jams really allow. I think that they anchor us. A lot of other spaces don't allow us to anchor an entire community with all of our ups and downs, our struggles. The idea is we're coming together, we're bringing our whole selves, we're gonna eat, we're gonna talk, we're gonna drink, and the music is really almost like an excuse to come together. But really, it's a beautiful time to be able to be in community, and I think that community jams are part of the essence of La Peña.
Yeah.
part of this large network of a world of artists and musicians and performers that are connected to this local hub here. The idea behind filming the community jams and capturing the stories of where the communities are at right now is so that we can take this as a blueprint moving forward to collecting stories and also just documenting amazing performances, things that are happening at La Peña. These cultural traditions are very important, and the cultural bearers that are leading the way are true gems of the Bay Area.
To say is thanks for all the arts community that held their ground. Survival came through people who reached out with artist relief funds, keeping the motors working and thinking about how we were going to come back. So I'd like to thank La Peña for that, La Peña for this and for marking our re-entry.
Thank you. I feel alive. I feel very happy. I have, this happiness all around my body right now. And I'm very thankful to be here today. And I'm very thankful to La Peña for holding this space for us today here, because it's like coming back to our family, our extended family that we haven't seen for a year. And it's very symbolic because we have families, a member that we don't see yet. So just starting here with the people that we do fandangos and we dance and we sing and we play and we just stay together when we have those fandangos, is just great. It's I don't know how to say. I just feel very alive. That's the word. Yeah.
Gracias, La Peña. Gracias al equipo de sonido y de video y de fotografía y de todo. Muchas gracias por el apoyo y que siga el fandango.